Very good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all my Benin brothers, my Benin sisters, my Edo brothers, my Edo sisters across the world. I wouldn't have responded over the incident that happened at the Oba of Benin Palace yesterday, but I just want to clear the air, especially this message is for you, the conveyor of Niger Wash, or I don't know your name, I've not met you before, and I doubt if you are a Benin son or an Edo son, because there is no good Edo son or Edo daughter, a Benin son or a Benin daughter, that will see his father being molested in public, being embarrassed or beaten in public, and will come out and be asking the people that are molesting or embarrassing or beating up his or her father, will be asking them, what did my father do? It is only a bastard child that does that. First of all, let me introduce myself to you, because you don't know me, and I don't know you, and I don't want to know you, because your message, life streaming yesterday shows that you are a biased person. You are a very biased reporter of issues. You could not ask for my name. You are taking side with your friend, Emmanuel Agbogun. You didn't ask what happened. First, was Emmanuel Agbogun the only person that came into the palace? Why were others not embarrassed? Emmanuel Agbogun, I make boast to say, is an enemy of Oba of Benin Palace and in general, Benin Kingdom people. You may not know what the damages Emmanuel Agbogun and his co-travelers are doing, because you are somewhere abroad, you feel you can just stay in the distance and be judging from there. I expected you, as a young man, an intelligent, we are supposed to be an intelligent young man, but you showed yourself yesterday by taking side, judging issue without hearing from the other side. Now, let me come to the common language. English is not our language. Let me come to the common language that everybody will understand, which is the pidgin English. Larry, you don't ask yourself whether not only Emmanuel Agbogun entered palace yesterday, follow protesters, come inside palace. Why was he singled out? Why I singled him out, drama come out? Because I did that because Emmanuel Agbogun have been anti-Benin. He has been anti-Oba Palace. Why Emmanuel Agbogun never go video in Papa house? Put out for social media. Say why Papa they do some things. Our Oba of Benin, now our royal father. I will not stand to see anybody insult my palace, the palace of the Oba of Benin, our palace. Emmanuel Agbogun should come and prove to the world if he is actually a Benin boy. He is not a Benin boy. I make bold to say that. I know what I'm talking about. If you want to criticize, let him go to his data state and criticize their royal institution there, their traditional institution there. He cannot come to my state, Edo state, to my Benin kingdom, and be criticizing when I know he's doing it wrongly. Did Emmanuel Agbogbo know? Emmanuel Agbogbo know say now Oba Palace, now be Ring Road. That we are museum day. Go reach Akwapava, go reach Igun, go reach Sapler Road, go reach Dormet House. All those places now palace, now Oba land. Then he went. Whether a person they pay him, I don't know what they you know, he's planning, they are planning evil, but it will never work. With people like me, they're there to resist them. You understand? Why he will go palace? Go, he don't even know the family where they get that those buildings. That buildings belong to the Oba of Benin Palace. It was given out to a particular family so that, you know, because they are royal family. Then Oba will not have rights to renovate his fence. That is by the way. Let me not go far. I just want you to know, Naija Wash, that your senselessness was shown yesterday. You are very senseless. And I doubt if you are actually a Benin son or an Edo son. Because you are trying to defend a man that is insulting your father indirectly. Let me say, Emmanuel Agbogun and his co-travelers, I knew them in 2010. They came to me to beg for my assistance. And I gave them assistance. And I taught them most of the things they know in the street today, in terms of agitation, in terms of protesting. I taught them. In the likes of Kola Edokpaye and others, I was sponsoring them. I make t-shirts, I make cap, I lead them in protest, and I pay for the media. Ask any of them if I'm owing them 50 naira. Ask them, any of them. Let them come out and say that they have given Kotisugbo 1 naira in their life. I'm the one giving them. You understand? They are my younger ones. But Emmanuel Agbogun went astray. Emmanuel Agbogun, let me ask him. Make una ask Emmanuel Agbogun. Olobo way they talk so. John Cena Shelege, where they call himself Prince. Later they can't give him a chieftaincy title. Una don't see where Prince they collect chieftaincy title. You know that they are all fake. He said his name now, Prince Ashelege, Johnson Ashelege. Now he went and collected chief tenancy title. Which is higher? Is it Prince or Chief? That is by the way. Johnson Ashelege is a known killer, a criminal. You understand? He had been terrorizing Olobo, Jubdon, for many years. Did you ever see Emmanuel Agbogbo protest against Johnson Ashelege or Kola Edokpaye protest against Johnson Ashelege for attacking the Enoge of Olobo and the Benin people there? If you attack the Enoge of Olobo, who are you attacking? Are you not attacking the Oba of Benin indirectly? Are you not attacking the Oba of Benin indirectly? Did you see Emmanuel Agbogun say any bad thing or resist what Johnson Ashelege was doing in Olobo? Instead, him and the likes of Kola Edokpaye, Esosa Ayewere, and others, they were supporting Johnson Ashelege killing Benin people in Olobo, fighting against the Enoge of Olobo, who is a representative of the Oba of Benin in Olobo Dukedom. The Oba of Benin is the overlord of all the lands around and across Benin Kingdom. Did you see Emmanuel Agbogun, Kola Edokpaye and others say anything bad against Justin Ashelege. Do you know why? Because he knows how to grease their hand. They are hungry boys looking for recognition, looking for money. I can never be compromised. I can never be compromised. Again, recently, Emmanuel Agbogun went to Obareti claiming that there is a community called Ubiaza Neugiame. Did Emmanuel Agbogun go to the Benin Traditional Council to ask if there is any community called Ubiaza or Ubiaza Neugiame in Benin Kingdom? He refused to do that because they are giving him money to cause crisis in Obareti. It's causing crisis there. You see him here and now protesting. Make now ask Emmanuel Agbogun. He don't go ask for palace whether there is a village or a community called Ubiaza or Ubiaza Nebo Giamen in Benin Kingdom. All the villages and communities in Benin Kingdom are gazetted. The names are all, and the head of those communities are all gazetted inside the Benin Traditional Council, covered by the law of the Traditional Council. There is a Traditional Council law existing in Edo State. Every day you see him leading protests with Ubiaza, the wrong people. There is no community called Ubiaza. Is Emmanuel Agbogun helping the Oba to repair Benin Kingdom, or is causing crisis in Benin Kingdom? These questions I'm asking you, Naija Wash, because you are very senseless. You just think you can dabble into issues without asking questions, without investigating. I don't have any personal issue with Emmanuel Agbogun. Emmanuel Agbogun is too small. It's too small for me to be having issues with. I'm only fighting him because he's fighting against Benin Kingdom. He's fighting against our Oba of Benin. An attack to any Benin man is an attack to me, because it's Ewusu Agbo. An attack to my Oba of Benin is an attack to me. My Oba of Benin is my God on earth. He's my father, my royal father. And again, let me brief you a little. If you don't know, I am the private land and debt recovery agent to the Oba of Benin. I have my appointment letter to that. Oba appointed me, saw me fit, and he saw that I have the love of Benin people. That was why he gave me that assignment. If police want to arrest you for your house, they don't tell you that commissioner of police now invite you. They don't tell you that AIG invite you, or DPO now invite you. So my Oba have given me authority to fight against the enemies of Benin Kingdom. And Emmanuel Agbogun is from Delta State. He's one of the enemies of Benin Kingdom, identified with all his activities in Benin Kingdom. He's been identified as an enemy. And if Emmanuel Agbogun comes to the palace today, tomorrow, next tomorrow, I will always throw him out. You hear? Naija Wash, you hear me? I go always throw him out. And if care is not taken, you, if you enter palace, I will throw you out, because you are supporting the enemies of the palace. Emmanuel Agbogun and that idiot, what is that his name? Mokiface. Mokiface, now they call him. We be slave for Germany there. So they are friends. They have been relating. If you see both of them, they are all working together, including Kola Adepayi. Recently, there's a village called Igbo Shodi in Ebudi. You have been Kola Adepayi, Talakawa, whatever that is parading. Watch it and see. Recently, people protested. The people of that village protested to the palace. Instead of the other side to protest, the rival side to protest to counter, to come to the palace and counter what those first ones. They went to Kola because they are all supporting the wrong people. Is it not the duty of Kola, if he's a sensible boy, to come to the palace and ask questions? What is really going on in Negosho the Nebudi? Instead, he's collecting money from them, causing more chaos. Instead of telling those people that, look, you're supposed to go to the palace and sort out your issues. But he's collecting money, media money, collecting this, you know, thinking that he's helping them. Why did he not ask them? People went to palace to protest against you. Why not go back to the palace and tell the palace that what these people came to tell me, tell the Oba, is a lie. This is the right thing. Then let the Oba call both sides and ask them what is going on. Instead, they ran to you, Kola, and you hosted them. Are you helping the Oba of Benin to repair the kingdom? And you claim you want to help the kingdom. You are agitating for the. I know you all. You know. I know you people. Emmanuel Agbogun, Kola Edokpa, you people know that I know you all very well. I know all of you very well. I am not here to spoil anybody's name. I don't have, you people don't even, you know, I don't have time for you people. You know that. Ever since you people knew me, I've been helping you people. Have you helped me for once? Or by giving me money or anything? Eh? Kola Edokpa, we protested for MPDC. For the rights of our people. I sponsored that protest. How much did you contribute? That protest that led us to prison. How much did you contribute? I spent most of the money. Then my boy, Dion Osaige, was there. He was part of it. He spent some money. Then Dion Laye, too. When we were in prison, you were blaming me. You were blaming me for fighting for the rights of the Benins. Eh? We are in prison. We came out by the grace of God. They begged us to come out. And we all came out. Okay? So, you working against the palace, you are working against the interest of the Benin people. And as a Benin man, I will fight you people. I will continue to fight you people. I will Emmanuel, you are boasting. Say, if you see me, you. Anywhere you see me in Benin, eh? Try yourself. You will meet your Waterloo. I promise you that. My name is Comrade Curtis Ewusu Agbo. I'm not afraid of speaking truth to power or to anybody. I will say it the way it is. I don't know how to lie. I'm not like you people that are begging for food, that lie to make money. I'm too big for you people. I'm a big fish. Okay? I'm not in your level at all. Emmanuel Agbogun, I advise you. It is either you go back to your state, Delta state. You claim you are Benin born. You cannot even speak Benin. You don't even know how to greet your Oba of Benin. It shows that you are a bon fool. Go back to school. Go. You were dropped out from University of Abuja. Come and prove me wrong now. Did you go to NYC? Do you have your NYC certificate? Come and prove me wrong. You were a thief, a campus thief in University of Abuja. Everybody know you. Come and prove me wrong. You are talking about you did not. You impregnated one of Johnson Asielegen's daughter. Come and prove me wrong. Am I your mate? If you come to palace today and I see you in palace, except I don't see you, I see you inside the palace of Yoruba, I will throw you out just as I did yesterday. Any of you that are pointing fingers, speaking directly or indirectly insults to the Oba of Benin Palace, the same thing I did to Emmanuel Agbogun yesterday, I will do it to all of you. Except you all repent, except you all come, those that have offended the palace, to come and write a letter of apology. If I sight you with my eyes inside palace, I will throw you out. Because you are enemies of the palace and you are enemies of the Benin people. So, Niger Watch, please be advised. Next time you hear something happening, hear from the other side. I don't have any personal issue with Emmanuel Agbogbo. He's not carrying my wife. I don't get anything. I don't do business with him. I don't have anything to do with him. The only issue I am having with him is insulting the palace of the Oba of Benin. He's insulting my Oba, and he will never take it. He is supporting evil in Benin Kingdom. How can a normal human being go and support a man like Johnson Achelege, who is a killer, a murderer, a kidnapper, a known one? It's obvious. The case is there. Everything is there. I have record. I don't just talk. So anybody that is supporting evil is my enemy. And is the enemy of the Oba of Benin. And is the enemy of Benin Kingdom. So my good people, I remind your humble brother, Curtis Egusa Ugbo, President, Benin Solidarity Movement. Thank you all and God bless.